Mr. Strange.
This is the trailer for the movie Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. It shows the desecration of the world he's dwelling in. There are a few lines that particularly resonate with our focus of interest today. Have a quick listen. These exact lines will have a significant influence on how the notion of multiverse is being played out. It'll also explain why Doctor Strange's world is collapsing. And so you might be wondering, just what happens if two distinct universes are united in some way through a portal? In this video, we will explore the science behind this version of the multiverse concept and beyond. If you are a fan of Marvel, this may be your most anticipated movie of the year. It may have far-reaching consequences for the future MCU films, and it is certainly worth seeing. And that's why the aim of this video isn't really about forecasting the story plots that will happen in the movie, because doing so would be a violation of cause and effect, a topic which we have already discussed in our previous video here. Instead, this video is an exploration of Doctor Strange multiverse, and more specifically, what it means to protect one reality, one universe, as portrayed in a trailer or the Disney Plus series, What If? Having gotten that out of the way, let's get to the meat of this. What do scientists have to say regarding the existence of a multiverse? Is there any scientific reference to support this concept in real life? According to physicist Max Tegmark, there are four different levels of multiverses, from thoughts that are generally accepted by prominent scientists to even some outlandish speculations. We'll simply go over the first two of these levels today. The level 1 multiverse is the least contentious. This is based on the fundamental notion that space is infinite, reaching out in all directions indefinitely towards the horizon. The assumption is that, since our universe is so vast and gigantic, it must replicate itself at some point, in another space or time. It is possible that life may start in a galaxy far, far away from where we are, and that life will develop into beings who will live in a world similar to Earth. If this is true, it would properly explain the presence of doppelgangers, aka beings who are slightly different from each other. For instance, Tom Holland's Spider-Man may very well coexist with Andrew Garfield's and Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to shatter a little bit of that sci-fi fantasy of yours. Dr. Tegmark concluded that if such a perfect pair of doppelgangers existed, they would be somewhere at the distance of 10 to the power of 118 meters away from one another, 3 times larger than our current observable universe. Now we're heading to the level 2 multiverse, an endless collection of various space-time dimensionalities. The basic idea here is that as the vacuum of space continues to expand, it permits many configurations of each physical constant to vary by a minuscule amount. Perhaps just a tiny change in those constants would allow one specific universe to have a different set of governing physical laws. It's analogous to a region of space where anti-gravity exists, kind of like when Doctor Strange was trapped in a psychedelic space. We might wonder naively, what's the worst that might happen if we modify the fundamental constants of our universe? Perhaps just a little alteration to its last digits. Scientists use the power of supercomputers to churn through the intertwined equations, potentially looking at the other sets of universes and unraveling the deep mysteries of what these alternate universes would look like. Here's a bigger picture of how that methodology works. We have the universe's parameters as a starting point. These include things like the value of cosmological constant, the gravitational constant, etc. Now, we add these rather peculiar numbers in each row, down to the last digit. And as a result, we have the universe as we know it. The gravitational pull, quark's mass, or even dark energy would be just right to allow the universe to exist. However, if we put a vastly different value in each of those rows, the simulation indicates that the only thing that would emerge is nothingness. Then we make another addition to our table, this time with something that is a little closer to our physical constants. So we copy these numbers, but adjust them somewhat. After a while, in the third possible universe, the same nothingness will arise in that reality. Even if we simply copy and paste the same numbers from our universe and tweak just one of the data points, we will also get nothing. You and I wouldn't exist. If we repeat this data entry for some time, we will discover immense pools of darkness and nothingness in the process. It appears that almost every other possible universe is completely devoid of life and matter. No galaxies, stars, or planets to speak of. Only a bleak outlook is presented.
And so, through this process of generating possible universes, we see that only a fraction of those actually exist.
And back to our main topic today, that one universe appears to be the one that Dr. Strange inhabits. As he tampers with the stability of space-time, he's able to open the multiverse gateway. This allows the possibility of seeing the different parallel universes, perhaps one where matter didn't rise at all. Humans, including the mystical Dr. Strange, are held in place by the power of gravity. However, in the alternate disruptive universe, tiny variations in the gravity constant will soon draw matter together into multiple black holes, enclosing the atomic material required for life. From this scene, we can see the two opposing interference between a stable universe and a disruptive one.
However, there are two missing points that I've kept hidden from you.
First of all, the constants of nature actually vary over time. Take, for instance, the fine-tuning constant. It has had a constantly changing value from the time of the Big Bang till where we are today. As a consequence, it could be that a constant that isn't correct now will result in a proper universe at a later point in time. Secondly, what if we keep filling in the various datasets from our table, but this time we keep doing it over and over again? All of the possible numbers, whether they are extremely big or small, slightly closer to a universe's constant, or perhaps something completely different. We repeat this process an endless numbers of time. It's possible that after a multitude of dead ends, we'll come upon one that sparks our attention. A universe where everyone is a mythical creature. Or a universe where a superhero exists, just with a different backstory and timeline. With these two missing points, I believe it is one of the reasons why, in No Way Home, there were two more Spider-Men from stable universes. Both of them originated from different timelines. Yet somehow, they can jump into the other universe and interact with it. The question of how someone could open a portal and find the exact time and location for one Spider-Man is completely a matter of luck. If Doctor Strange portal is provided, it just means that the possibilities are accessible. But targeting the doorway to the right universe, the right timing, or even the right person is just about astronomically impossible. It appears as though the film writer decided to make that happen by force. They made it so that the probability is so highly fine-tuned that the three Spider-Men will appear in one movie. Perhaps you're wondering if similar things, I mean extremely coincidental things, are happening in your life. It may be one you're not aware of, originating in a realm above your own. Just like movie actors are unaware that their fictional fate is being predetermined by some other entity outside of their movie reality. And that entity is the writer.
If you made it to the end of this video, we just wanted to say thank you. There's a lot more that we wanted to cover in this topic, but we figured it would be best to separate these types of content. So a few days ago, we launched our YouTube membership. That's where we include deep dives into some of the most interesting topics that made you question our perception of reality. Come check out our membership and get early bird access to some of the extended content that we have published. I'll see you there.